I believe that discovering and supporting people who drive development of human society and serve as role models for our times is also a noble mission for a company to fulfill. Times of change and challenges leading the balanced development of mankind's scientific progress and spiritual culture. Since the first award ceremony in 1991, the Hoan Prize has had a meaningful history of discovering and honoring those who have contributed to humanity. In 1994, the Hoan Prize Committee, comprising respected figures in each field, was established to secure fairness and independence of the prize. Honoring the award's 10th anniversary in 2000, the basis of the Hoan Prize was solidified, and we celebrated the 20th anniversary in 2010. A special prize was awarded to the Nobel Foundation. Since 2012, eminent foreign scholars participated in the evaluation, gaining global prestige in the evaluation, and in 2020, the Science Prize was expanded and reorganized, contributing to the support of Korea's science and technology sector and enhancing its competitiveness. In 2021, by changing the name of the prize to Samsung Hoan Prize, a stronger basis was laid for a new leap forward. The history of achievement and progress written by the Samsung Hoan Prize. It is deeply rooted in late Hoan Byung-chul Lee's spirit of business serving the national interest and putting talent above all else, committed to the nation's and people's prosperity. Inheriting this spirit, in 1998, late Chairman Lee Gun-hee established the Samsung Hoan Prize with a firm belief in corporate social responsibility.
Over the past decades, when Korea has taken the most impressive steps forward on the international scientific stage, this prize has given recognition and encouragement to important achievements to the benefit of both the Korean society and to the world.
Endless exploration of the unknown, driving development of science and civilization, pioneers leading a healthy and happy life for mankind, enriching the spiritual culture of mankind, keeping the value of the community with noble sacrifice and love. The Samsung Hoan Prize seeks to create a mature and dignified society where these people are given due respect. The Samsung Hoan Prize has engaged in an endless effort to seek candidates in and outside the country with the help of special nomination committee where 3,000 people served, and by posting announcements in prestigious journals including Science, Nature, and Cell. These candidates undergo a rigorous 5-month screening process of a selection committee comprised of domestic and international scholars. The selection committee make their final judgment based on the excellence of research, originality of creation, and contributions to humanity, human society, and do their best to select the best achievement every year.
I think the Hoan Prize has an extremely high standard of selection process. It has great integrity.
It seems to me to encapsulate all the best of procedures that other people use.
The Hoan Foundation, along with the operation of the Samsung Hoan Prize, is devoted to spreading science culture in Korea and conveying dreams and visions to future generations. In 2002, the foundation co-hosted the Nobel Prize Centennial Exhibition with the Nobel Foundation, which has led the scientific civilization of mankind. Starting in 2021, Hoan Prize laureates and world-renowned scholars were invited to summer and winter season online lectures to discuss the latest science and humanities knowledge, as well as various topics to help the youth plan for their future. Through these events, we support the bright dreams and visions of young people who are our future hope. On the road to unstoppable progress, the Samsung Hoan Prize will continue to stand by the paragons of the times and will make our way forward into the future. Good afternoon, everyone. I'd like to introduce myself. I am the MC for 2023 Samsung Hoan Prize Award Ceremony. My name is Misorang Seo. Thank you very much. As we've seen from the video, the Samsung Hoan Prize Award Ceremony is a special occasion where we present the prize to individuals for their outstanding achievements in the six areas of sciences, medicine, engineering, arts, and community service. And I would like to thank all the guests to celebrate this moment. We have the winners of the Samsung Hoan Prize on stage. Please give them a big round of applause. Thank you very much. Now we will begin the award presentation ceremony. I'd like to invite Chairman Hwang Sik Kim of the Foundation for his opening remark. Please welcome him with a big hand. Honorable Dr. Jisun Im, Dr. Kyungshin Choi, Dr. Yang Kuk Sun, Dr. Marcia Haegis, pianist Song Jin Cho, and Chairman Yong Jun Park of Global Care. I have called out the most proud and honorable names as of this moment. You are the proud laureates of the 33rd Samsung Hoan Prize 2023. Your distinguished achievements in academics, arts, and social community service have furthered the welfare of humanity and marked special milestones in practicing love for mankind. My congratulations go to you and your family and all the Global Care volunteer workers for all the support. Congratulations. During the past 5 months, we have had experts on the selection committee of the Hoan Foundation who went through a thorough screening and evaluation process. And it is a great pleasure and pride that we present the prize today. The Samsung Hoan Prize was established in 1990 to honor the noble spirit of public service espoused by Hoan Byung-chul Lee by the late Lee Kun-hee. To date, the Samsung Hoan Prize was presented to individuals who have made great strides in science and technology as well as culture and arts, and also community service to recognize and encourage their hard work and dedication. Going forward, the Hoan Foundation will continue to contribute to creating a beautiful and abundant society where mankind can enjoy balanced harmony of material as well as spiritual culture in the 21st century. We will do our best to undergo fair screening and selection process with integrity to further enhance the authority and prestige of the prize itself and in turn upgrade the national status as well. I would like to take this opportunity to express my deepest gratitude to late Chairman Kun-hee Lee, Chairman Jae-yong Lee, members of the Hoan Foundation, members of the Hoan Prize Committee. Thank you. And we have had outstanding work done by Dr. Hyun-taek Kwon and the jury, and they selected outstanding laureates out of so many great candidates. based on your expertise. And also, I'd like to thank the foreign advisory scholars for your valuable input. Once again, a big congratulations to all the winners. I wish you further success and greater accomplishments in your future endeavors. I wish the very best of luck and health to all the guests and to the online participants who have joined us to congratulate the winners. I wish the very best. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Chairman Kim Hwang-sik, for your kind words. Next, I would like to invite the chair of the selection committee on behalf of the 46 selection committee members. The chair professor Hyun-taek Kan of SNU will report on the selection process. So let me invite Professor Hyun. It has been my honor to participate in the selection process for 2023 Hoem Prize. On behalf of 46 members of the selection committee, let me report on the selection process. Composed of renowned scholars and experts from Korea and overseas in the areas of research, arts, and community service, the selection committee received candidate nominations until the end of October 2022, and for 5 months until March this year, the selection committee did its utmost to select winners of each category who have the most notable achievements. In line with the spirit of the prize and with the mission of selecting outstanding winners who have achieved world-class achievements, the selection committee for each category focused on excellence in research, originality of creative activities, and contribution to human society. In the academic categories, 22 top domestic experts and 10 distinguished international scholars, including Nobel Prize laureates, participated in the process. And in addition, an advisory panel composed of 45 foreign experts evaluated the candidates' achievements to further verify international excellence of the candidates' achievements. For the arts category, we conducted multidimensional and in-depth examination of the past, present, and future values, as well as artistic evaluation of works and creative activities. And for the community service category, we conducted thorough verification, such as visiting the candidates' activity sites and conducting in-depth interviews via video. Through this thorough process, the selection committee recommended final candidates for the categories to the Hoem Prize Committee, which finalized the list of winners for the 2023 Hoem Prize after another round of deliberation process. And with that, we have the winners for this year's Hoem Prize. The winner for this year's Science Prize in the Physics and Mathematics category is Dr. Im Ji-sun of POSTEC. Dr. Lim revised an innovative method to calculate the total energy required for the formation of solid matter and made significant contribution to the field of computational materials physics to reveal the structure and properties of solids without actual experiments. The winner of the Science Prize in the Chemistry and Life Sciences category is Dr. Kyung-shin Choi of the University of Wisconsin in the U.S. She has conducted research on electrode materials and catalysts, which are essential for photoelectric reactions that use light to split water, which has contributed to the field of energy science by enabling the production of high-efficiency hydrogen. The winner of the Engineering Prize is Dr. Son Yang-guk of Hanyang University. He applied the concentration gradient structure to the cathode material of lithium-ion batteries for the first time in the world, dramatically improving the stability and lifespan of the battery. He has contributed greatly to the next generation battery field. The winner of the prize in medicine is Dr. Marsha Haggis of Harvard Medical School in the U.S. She discovered for the first time in the world that cancer cells recycle ammonia, which is known as a waste product of cellular metabolism, and accelerates the proliferation of cancer cells, which has contributed greatly to the field of cancer metabolism. The winner of the Arts Prize is pianist Song Jin-cho. In 2015, he became the first Korean to win the Chopin International Piano Competition, and he has been performing actively on the world stage, and he was highly regarded for his contribution to raising the status of Korean arts and culture. Finally, the winner in the community service category is a Global Care. As an international healthcare NGO founded in 1997, it was highly regarded for its leadership role in emergency medical relief and international health cooperation at home and abroad, and for practicing humanity that transcends national borders. On behalf of the selection committee, I would like to express my immense respect and deep appreciation to the winners for their hard work and dedication. I would like to extend my heartfelt congratulations on receiving these Samsung Hwam Awards today. I hope that you will continue to devote yourself to making greater contributions to the nation and entire human society.
네, 현태권 교수님 발표해 주셨습니다.
Thank you, Professor Taekwon Hyun.
그럼 지금부터 수상자에 대한
And now we will present the award to the winners. First, Physics and Mathematics Award.
물질에 보이지 않는 성질
Can we make the invisible properties of matter visible? This out-of-the-box thinking pioneered the field of physics that had not existed before. It was impossible to mathematically and accurately calculate the properties of solids composed of countless atoms. Dr. Ji-sun Im's research has gone beyond that limit. He was the first to design a method that could quickly and accurately calculate the total energy required for solid formation. The result calculated by Dr. Ji-sun Im's formula and the actual experimental result matched 99%. As quick and accurate calculation was proven possible, a new field of physics called computational materials physics was born. Dr. Ji-sun Im's calculation method is the most widely used standard method in the world. Dr. Ji-sun Im discovered the characteristics of solid matters composed of nuclei and electrons using computer calculations. Researchers all over the world are using it, and it will have a ripple effect in many, many wide fields. Also, through the calculation method he developed, he discovered for the first time in the world that when carbon nanotubes are bundled together, they have semiconductor properties. Compared to our generation, the performance of supercomputers has increased tremendously. So I hope that my calculation techniques can be used to develop more diverse and groundbreaking new materials in the future. As a pioneer in computational materials physics, Dr. Ji-sun Im's method, which enabled calculation of the properties of solids, forms the core of a supercomputer program and converged with AI technology, is contributing greatly to technological evolution in semiconductors, chemistry, and new drug development. Chairman Hwang Shik Kim of the Hwam Foundation will present the award. We would like to invite Chairman Kim to the stage. Dr. and Mrs. Ji-sun Im, please come forward. The prize winner will receive a diploma, medal, and cash prize of 300 million Korean won. Congratulations. Please give them a big round of applause.
Yes, please look at the camera in front. Thank you. And we would like to ask Dr. Jisun Im for his acceptance speech. That's the video that I am in, and it's the first time that I'm seeing it. And I was wearing my hair long in the video, but I got a haircut for the award ceremony. And I did not receive any help from ChatGPT in writing this acceptance speech. It is purely from my head. First of all, it is a great honor to be awarded the Samsung Hoam Prize in Physics and Mathematics, and I would like to express my deepest gratitude to the Hoam Foundation and officials who have devoted their time and effort from nomination all the way to selection. I could not have received such an honor today if it had not been for the following. My teachers and mentors had worked so hard to lay the foundation for basic science in Korea under very challenging circumstances. I was very lucky because when I returned to Korea in 1986, the conditions for academic research gradually improved and I could receive research funding from the Ministry of Education and the Ministry of Science and Technology. And added to the luck, there was the direct contribution of excellent fellow professors, colleagues, and students. So all these made it possible for me to receive the award today. Also, like many other scientists, I did not have enough time to spend with my family because I was busy with research, and I became a very boring husband and father. But nonetheless, my wife and my son and daughter put up with me, understood me, and encouraged me. So thank you. When I was little, I was curious about natural phenomena, and that curiosity led me to choose physics as my major. I challenged myself in a new field of computational physics and employed myself in one research field for 40 years. I hope that my winning the prize will be a small encouragement to junior scientists who are devoted to a single research theme their whole life in the area of basic science. While I happily imagine the future Samsung Hoam Prize winners in my head, there is one topic that I want to think about together with them. Basic science ultimately contributes to the development of our society and mankind, but it is not a goal-oriented research area that aims to immediately solve life's problems. Rather, I remember the senior scientist saying that basic science's shining moment comes when new phenomena are discovered and profound theories are identified, not when it is applied to solving everyday problems, and I agreed with them. However, the problems facing humanity, such as the recent COVID-19 and the global climate crisis, unravel in a very urgent and serious manner. And new technologies such as AI, ChatGPT, and quantum information are changing society at a rapid speed. This new situation poses a difficult question to junior scientists and engineers and to the future of the globally prestigious Samsung Hoam Prize. How can our research topics strike a good balance between search for truth and solving mankind's problems? And what criteria will be applied to evaluate the achievements? I hope to find the answer together, however challenging it might be. Thank you. Thank you very much. Congratulations, Dr. Jisun Im.
Next, the prize for chemistry and life sciences. A little girl who was dreaming of becoming a pianist after some 30 years. became a great scientist who is making contributions to solving humanity's energy and environmental problems. I was so nervous on the stage. I thought maybe I am not fit for stage performance. To me, well, chemistry, it feels like a mine where treasures are hidden. There's so much unknown there. So chemistry is a discipline that gives me an opportunity to continue to take on new challenges and achieve progress. Clean energy, which is directly related to sustainability of humanity, was a field that stimulated Dr. Choi's curiosity. It was because even hydrogen, which is often called the cleanest energy, was actually produced using fossil fuels that emit greenhouse gases. It's been discovered that hydrogen can be produced without carbon emissions through photolytic process using sunlight, but it was not able to mass produce hydrogen. So scientists focused on developing catalysts to maximize the efficiency of photoelectrodes to overcome this limitation. Dr. Choi's research completely turned upside down the existing research trends. It is not just using highly efficient catalysts to maximize hydrogen generation, but she proved that the use of another catalyst that is low on efficiency but is optimally combined with photoelectrodes lead to maximum hydrogen generation. And she announced a double-layer catalyst structure that she designed. This innovative approach is the most commonly used method in hydrogen fuel using sunlight, and it has inspired so many scientists and has become a basis for new research.
Dr. Choi is an outstanding scientist, and she has excelled in being innovative in designing and creating novel catalysts for hydrogen generation, and also photocathodes converting carbon dioxide and water into solar fuels. So she managed to make several step change progress and results that affecting this field, her field.
Her curiosity has gone beyond hydrogen energy, and she's now conducting research on the use of organic waste, such as tree barks and plant stalks, to produce clean energy and clean materials. And she's also studying how to purify and reuse seawater and wastewater, and continuing her research on new ways to recycle resources. In order for us to continue to survive in the future, we need to constantly produce and use energy, food, and materials. And we have been harming the environment through these processes. So my dream is to change each of these processes to be a little more eco-friendly and help create a more sustainable future for humanity. And that is my goal. As a leader in clean energy science, she loves science and the environment, and she is a delightful innovator who tries to solve problems from an original perspective. So we look forward to a new hope for humanity that Dr. Choi will continue to present. Now, Dr. Kyungshin Choi, please come forward. Congratulations. Please send her another round of big applause. Dr. Choi, please go and deliver your acceptance speech. I have watched many Oscar award ceremonies, but never dreamed that I, who am not an actress but a scientist, would ever use the following line as part of my award acceptance speech. Producer and director, thank you so much for making such a great film of me.
I would also like to thank the Hoem Foundation and everyone involved with the selection and presentation of this award for putting in so much effort to make my receiving this award such an extraordinary and proud experience. I would like to take a moment to think about how I have become the scientist that I am today. Behind every important decision, there were always teachers. Chemistry became my favorite subject because of my high school chemistry teacher. And I chose to major in solid-state chemistry because of my master study advisor who taught me solid-state chemistry so well. Furthermore, I decided to become a professor in the United States thanks to my doctoral and postdoctoral advisors who told me that I would become a great professor and guided me through that path. Without these teachers, my life would have been very different. So thank you, teachers. I also want to send my gratitude and encouragement to all the teachers in the world who are dedicated to teaching their students even at this very moment. Next, I think about all the students who have worked with me. I may not be an easy teacher to work with because I set high expectations for them to be extremely meticulous in their research, as otherwise, it is not possible to obtain accurate and reproducible results. Without any complaints, my students go the extra mile and work even more meticulously and thoroughly than I do. Without their dedication to science, it would not have been possible for me to receive this award today. It has been a tremendous joy and honor to share a part of my life with those who share the same passion for science. There are also many mentors, collaborators, and colleagues of mine who supported and encouraged me in many ways. I would like to let them know how inspiring they are, and my interactions with them have been vital for me to grow to be a better scientist. Lastly, I would like to send my sincere gratitude to my family and friends who have supported me and re-energized me throughout my life. Now, I think about the weight of this award. When I know nothing is for free, what should I do in return for this award? Probably, I should choose to do something I am good at and I like. I am good at working hard and I like to do research. Even now, when I come up with a new solution or idea at night while thinking about a problem I could not solve, I get too excited to sleep. Judging from the fact that my heart still races thinking about what I do, even after working for more than 20 years, I believe that being a scientist is the most wonderful job in the world. I frequently tell my students that our life is not forever and we do not have much time. Thus, although all research is fun, we need to prioritize what to do and focus. Following my own advice for the remaining time I have, I will deliberately choose impactful research topics about energy and the environment, and I will work on those topics fiercely and joyfully. I will have a blast doing science. Thank you.
Dr. Choi, thank you so much and congratulations.
And now, Engineering Award. An era in which battery technology determines the national competitiveness. The future where batteries will be required in many areas and in large scale. There are many very good technologies in the future, but I think batteries are the most important, and I think that this battery industry will be Korea's next generation growth engine and Korea's staple industry. The development of secondary batteries that enable long driving range with just one-time charge and without risk of fire has been a hot topic in the battery field for a long time.
If you increase the nickel content of the cathode material, which determines the capacity and performance of the battery, you can drive longer. But the problem is that the more you use it, the shorter the lifespan and higher the combustion risk. Dr. Yang-guk-sun presented a method to dramatically improve the stability and lifespan of secondary batteries and identify the cause of side effects, providing a solution. He introduced for the first time in the world the concentration gradient cathode material technology that increased the nickel content at the center of a cathode particle. Dr. Sun's breakthrough technology is evaluated as a futuristic battery material in that it solved battery capacity, lifespan, stability, and price issues, and has received keen interest from the academia and the industry.
An engineer really wants to see his ideas come into a product at the end. He does great things, and I know there's one battery company that's using those cathode materials for advanced electric vehicle applications such as buses and trucks and things like that.
Dr. Yang-guk-sun's technology is Korea's proprietary technology, becoming a new game changer in the global secondary battery industry. I think it is very important to know how to utilize energy well, create clean energy, and then raise energy efficiency. And I want to contribute to the battery industry that can form Korea's industrial competitiveness. Dr. Yang-guk-sun, who has stuck to the same path for the past 20 years for world-class battery technology, his research on K-battery technology is still ongoing. Dr. and Mrs. Yang-guk-sun, please come forward. Congratulations. Please give them a big round of applause. We would like to ask Dr. Sun for his acceptance speech. First of all, it's a tremendous honor to receive the honorable award honoring the will of late Hwang Byung-chul Lee, who set the foundation for high-tech industries so that Korea could rise from the ashes of the war to join the ranks of advanced countries. There are many other deserving excellent researchers, but I believe the reason why I was given the prize is to encourage me to continue further research and to further develop our country's science and technology for industrial patriotism and cultivation of human resources that Hoam was devoted to. In the 1990s, when I started researching lithium secondary batteries, Japan was the only country in the world that was able to produce the batteries, and Korea was new to the area where research and development had not yet been conducted. I thought that for the competitiveness of the battery industry in Korea, it was necessary to have excellent material technology, not the development of a manufacturing process with which you could easily catch up by investing time and capital. In the early days, when the development direction of lithium secondary battery was not clear, even though it was not a popular research topic at the time, I thought that the development of cathode materials would be more important than anything else, and I understood and overcame the fundamental problems of cathode materials without being swayed by more trendy research topics. There have been various research achievements, but the most meaningful achievement is the successful development of concentration gradient cathode material. The concentration gradient cathode material technology, both inexpensive and performance and stability proven, has been transferred to several domestic companies and has been successfully mass-produced and is being currently used in EVs. I feel most rewarded that I contributed to increasing the driving range of EVs and making them more popular with innovative materials. Ahead of the full-fledged adoption of the electric vehicles, the secondary battery market is growing at an unprecedented rate. So far, Korean secondary battery companies have world-class competitiveness, but in order for Korean companies to lead the global market in the future, they must have better source material technology. And so my next goal is to develop innovative materials to develop electric vehicles that charge quickly and do not have to worry about the driving range. In the future, there will be many important things to do to vitalize the battery industry in Korea. But from a macro perspective, I believe that nurturing excellent talents is the surest preparation for the future. To this end, the Department of Battery Engineering was established with the goal of fostering top-notch talent who will lead the future secondary battery energy technology. My favorite saying is 청출어람, which means the blue color that derived from Navy is deeper blue than Navy, meaning the students become smarter than the teachers. I hope that young scientists set challenging goals and conduct honest research to create stable industries for our country and to raise the status of K-science and technology. If you have confidence in your field of study, please have patience and try to maintain a long-term horizon. There are many people who helped me receive the honor today. I would like to express my deep love and gratitude to my wife and sons for their constant encouragement and support so that I could pursue my research in comfort. Although there have been many hardships while doing research, my students have shown faith in me and followed my lead in the lab day and night, so I'd like to thank them as well. And I'd like to share the joy with my students. I'd like to express my gratitude once again to all of you who helped me win the Samsung Hoan Prize, and I will continue to reflect on the meaning of the prize and devote myself to contributing to the development of the battery technology and fostering future talent. Thank you.
Next, the prize for medicine.
Doing science is like solving unsolved mysteries. It's kind of like solving a puzzle or being an explorer. And you are learning things for the first time that nobody else knows. When I saw mitochondria for the first time, I thought mitochondria were very beautiful organelles and really elegant and dynamic and exciting organelles to study. We wanted to understand, what do cancer cells control inside them? How do cancer cells use metabolites in order to grow and proliferate and survive?
Understanding how cancer cells are supplied with nutrients for proliferation is crucial in developing cancer treatments. When most scientists were focused on the relationship between cancer cells and nutrients, Dr. Haygis turned their attention to ammonia, which is waste product generated in the process of cancer cells breaking down nutrients. She discovered that ammonia produced by cancer cells is not released like normal cells, but is rather reused as nutrient for cancer cell proliferation. For the first time in the world, she demonstrated that ammonia contributes to the acceleration of growth and proliferation of cancer cells. The renewed attention is now paid to the role of ammonia thanks to Dr. Haigis's research, and it has opened the possibility for developing new cancer treatments by suppressing the reuse of ammonia inside cancer cells.
Dr. Haigis has reframed the existing scientific dogma around cancer cells, introducing the possibility of new therapeutic interventions. And the principles of her findings in cancer immunology and cell metabolism are now being extended to many kinds of cancer and to other cell types, like immune cells.
The relationship between cancer cells and ammonia discovered thanks to her thinking outside of the box. Her creative research is creating a new wave in cancer treatment research. Now, Dr. Marcia Haigis and Mr. Haigis, please come forward.
Professors Marcia and Kevin Haigis, please come forward to the center of the stage to receive your prize.
Congratulations. Please give them another round of big applause.
Professor Haigis, may we ask for your acceptance speech?
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, fellow laureates and Samsung Hoam Prize Committee members. It is a tremendous honor to be here tonight with you all as a recipient of the 2023 Samsung Hoam Prize in Medicine. I'm incredibly grateful to the Hoam Foundation, the prize committee, and to all of the individuals who supported my nomination. This award really reflects the behind-the-scenes support and efforts of so many individuals that I want to acknowledge here tonight. First, I'm indebted to my students, the postdoctoral fellows in my lab, and all of the current and past lab members. They're really the heroes who perform the studies, the creative, curiosity-driven research that is being recognized here tonight with this prize. I'm fortunate to have many dedicated mentors throughout my training and my career. For instance, my graduate advisor, Dr. Ronald Raines, and generous collaborators, colleagues of Harvard Medical School, colleagues within the cancer metabolism and immune metabolism research community. The science that we do today is really a team effort, and it requires teamwork with a diversity in expertise. I'm truly privileged to be part of this amazing scientific community. Also, very importantly, I'm grateful to my family, to my husband and partner, Kevin, for his unwavering belief in me, both as a person and as a scientist, and to my children, Michael, Andrew, and Benjamin. You inspire me every day to dream big. I'm thankful to my siblings. I'm thankful to my parents, Errol and Sunja Hebert. Although they are not scientists, and my mother didn't always have the same opportunity for formal education as I did, throughout every step of my training, my parents always provided a foundation of support for my own education and for the deep pride that I have in my own Korean heritage. As a research scientist, it's always been a personal dream to work on a puzzle that, when solved, has the potential to contribute to human health. For me, working on mitochondria offered a piece of that puzzle. Mitochondria provide our cells with energy. But I became really curious to understand what else they do and how their function could be hijacked and used in cancer and in disease. Furthermore, mitochondria use fuels, but they also generate waste products like ammonia. It has been a tremendously satisfying journey to map out some of the ways that mitochondria use different fuels and even waste products, and to understand how mitochondrial metabolites contribute to human health and cancer. There is clearly more work to do in the future, and that's the exciting part of science. I'm looking forward to future mitochondrial research, asking new questions, and hopefully solving new and more puzzles. Thank you so much again for recognizing our work.
Next is the prize in arts. Before I go up on the stage, I say a little prayer for all of those who love my music. I do not consider music as a job or an occupation, but it is rather actually my whole life. Well, I think I wanted to be a pianist because I love playing the piano.
First prize and gold medal goes to San Jin Cho.
It was one of the most important events in my life, and by winning this competition, it helped me play music I love more freely. When I started to play more professionally, I thought that maybe I would not be as nervous when I play, let's say, hundreds of times. But actually, the more I perform, the more I get nervous. And what's different now is that now I am used to feeling nervous.
Uh, What is important for me is to play in a way that the audience can see the forest, not the individual trees. So while details matter, it is important to let them feel and experience where the climax is. So I really need to study the musical scores thoroughly, and my goal is to perform more music in a way that I can be satisfied with. For the award presentation, due to Mr. Cho's overseas concert schedule, his mentor and teacher, Professor Emeritus Shin-Soo Jung of Seoul National University, will receive the award on his behalf. So please come forward, Professor Shin. Professor, thank you very much. Now, pianist Sungjin Cho is joining us online to deliver his acceptance speech. So let's invite him for his speech. Hello everyone, I am Cho Sungjin. First of all, my sincere apologies for not being able to attend the Samsung Hoam Prize Award Ceremony in person due to my concert schedules and delivering my remarks online. It is my tremendous honor and pleasure to receive the 2023 Hoam Prize Arts Award. I remember playing the piano in the 2016 Hoam Award Ceremony for a congratulatory performance, and I am honored that after 7 years I became the recipient of the award. I know that the Hoam Prize is awarded every year to individuals who have made outstanding achievements in their respective fields, and I'm actually very happy to receive such a big award for me, even though my growth as a musician is still ongoing. But it also gives me a sense of responsibility. I would like to express my gratitude to the Samsung Hoam Prize Committee for choosing me to receive the prize. I would also like to express my gratitude to the two teachers, Ms. Soo Jung Shin and Ms. Sung Yun Park, who taught me a lot to get to where I am today. Also, thanks to Prime Minister Han Seung-soo, Chairman Min Nam-kyu, Chairman Kim Il-gon, and other seniors who supported me quietly since I was a child, I feel that I am here today. And although I cannot mention all of them, I would like to take this opportunity to thank all of those who believed in me and helped me along the way. And I want to share this honor with all of them. Although I am the youngest Hoam Prize winner, and I'm still rather young, for the past 23 years since I started playing the piano at the age of 6, I have devoted almost every day to practicing the piano and devoting a lot of time to studying music, and I have experienced trials and joys participating in world-class music competitions. And the fact that so many people have recognized me and selected me as the winner of the Hoam Prize has made me feel that my time with the piano has not been wasted. I believe that the Hoam Prize that has been given to me today is to give courage to young musicians who are working tirelessly as Koreans in the world classical music industry without losing my original intention. And it also means that I should continue to walk as I have been doing in the past. And so I will continue to try to walk on the right path. Finally, I would like to express my gratitude to my mentor and my master, Professor Soo Jung Shin, who has believed in me even though I was a stubborn and rather unkind student, and has always been on my side. She has devoted her life to the education and development of Korean classical music. I would also like to thank her for receiving the award on my behalf. Thank you very much. Thank you very much once again for your time and congratulations on receiving the award.
And now, Community Service Award. Just now, it was reported there were a number of confirmed cases of COVID-19 in Daegu and Gyeongbuk. Daegu recorded the highest number of new confirmed cases, surpassing the first round of the pandemic. Today, the first death occurred in Daegu, 2,000 and more in just Daegu area. The beginning of the pandemic, Daegu, where all daily life has come to a halt due to an unprecedented crisis. Amidst the chaos, Daegu Dongsan Hospital was fighting back to block the spread of the virus to other areas, acting as the line of defense. But it was a situation where nothing was prepared. The number of severely ill patients suddenly increased. There was no professional medical staff, and medical equipment was in short supply. The number of confirmed cases skyrocketed, and critically ill patients in a life or death situation increased. But there was an absolute shortage of professional medical staff, medical equipment, and ICU units to treat them. In addition, with COVID-19 spreading around the world, the supply chain was disrupted, blocking supply of medical equipment essential for treatment. First, there was shortage of medical personnel. As the number of patients increased, there was a shortage of ICUs, so patients were dying because they could not be hospitalized. So to be honest, I was very scared. There was a group who took the lead in supporting the intensive care unit by dispatching medical staff specializing in critical care patients and supplying medical equipment necessary for treatment. It is Korea's first international healthcare NGO, Global Care. Overcoming the extreme anxiety and fear of the pandemic, we are able to return to our daily lives thanks to Global Care's hard work. For the past 26 years, Global Care dispatched medical teams without hesitation to anywhere in the world where there were people suffering from poverty, disease, war, and disaster. But they are silent do-gooders working without any publicity, going to places where real help is needed and not getting attention from others. I think that is the reason for our organization's existence. What makes them actively seek disaster areas that no one dares to go? I was part of the work saving people's lives. We helped people to live in dignity. There's something noble about being able to treat people and to save people's lives. I think this place made me think about why I chose this occupation and what I need to do. It gave me a chance to think about that. Furthermore, Global Care is a model for international health activities which seeks and supports places in need based on local networks accumulated with medical expertise and long years of experience. Global Care is love. Without love, we cannot do anything. Love is warm. It's warm love. Those who are willing to share everything that they have and are dedicated to making a world where everyone is healthy. Global Care. We have co-representatives Park Yong-jun and Chu Song-yi of Global Care. Please come forward. Congratulations. Please give them another round of applause. We would like to ask Mr. Yongjun Park for his acceptance speech. We are engaged in tuberculosis eradication project in Morocco, applying new technologies with the help of mobile health through medicine box made in Korea and the smartphone. The local tuberculosis cure rate went up significantly. Global care, which started in Korea, is now present in 15 countries. We are providing relief efforts and assisting in the recovery of those affected by devastating disasters such as the Ukraine war and earthquake that hit Turkey and Syria. Global Care has a dream that the little gestures that we make in improving healthcare of the world will lead to salvation of vulnerable populations living in Southeast Asia, India, the Middle East, Africa, and Latin America. Christian Medical Fellowship Korea, that follows the teachings of missionaries Ellen Evison and Pae Do-sun, continue to train and nurture medical staff who have the same dreams as us. I would like to thank everyone for giving us the Samsung Hoem Prize. My special thanks goes to Mr. Pyeongsu Kim, mentor and chairman of Global Care Board and former president of Yonsei University, who have led us on this journey for 30 years. And I'd also like to thank God for allowing us to establish Global Care and to serve with so many good people. Thank you.
This concludes the award presentation for the 2023 Samsung Hoem Prize. Once again, congratulations to all the prize recipients. Next, we will have the special performance stage to congratulate the winners. The performer is violinist Park Soo-ye. She was nominated for the instrumental category of the Recording of the Year at the Gramophone Classical Music Awards in 2022, and she's also receiving instrument sponsorship from Samsung Foundation of Culture. Along with her, we have with us pianist Ilya Rashkovsky, who has received high prizes at many international competitions such as Long Thibaut Crapang Craspen competition and the Queen Elizabeth competition, is serving as professor at Songshin Women's University. The music piece that they will perform requires sophisticated techniques, so it is not easy to perform, which is the introduction and rondo Capriccioso A minor, Opus 28, composed by Gamyu Sangsangs. Today, violinist Park Soo-ye will perform this piece of music. Please welcome them with a big round of applause.
Thank you for that wonderful performance. Now this concludes the 33rd Samsung Hoan Prize Award Ceremony. Once again, congratulations to all the Hoan Prize recipients. Thank you. And congratulations. The Hoan Foundation will continue to strive for advancement and humanity of our society and will make sure that this prize will become even more prestigious awards. And I would also like to express my deepest gratitude to all of those who are attending in person or joining us online. Thank you so much for your participation. Thank you.